own part.
So the social side is what you can do yourself, what we can do for you, but the legal side is basically the job of professionals in this business.
Okay. To the part two of that question, is it advisable for the prospective buyer to pay instrumentally? Because I'm not sure. Maybe there are some people out there who think it's right. Can you advise them? Because when it comes to estate purchase, that's land in estates, or there's a private estate, I know there is something about paying in installments. So what do you advise? Is it advisable?
What should they do about it? When you are dealing with private developers, you mean?
Yes.
And they pay in the private estate whereby they give 24-hour security, they have their building, they have their transformer, they have their security on ground, they have everything for them. So that's fine. This group is what all most on the DS are running to now, which is not bad, to be honest. But if you have the money to pay outright, I would advise you to do it. Unless you are dealing with a renowned developer. Because in the city of Lagos today, everybody is nearly a developer.
I must be honest with you. If you have 2 acres of land, you become a developer.
The land which they are even selling for you does not have a CFO. They don't have a gazette for it. So, if you buy such land on an instrumental basis, you are doing a bad business, my brother.
So, even if you want to buy from an estate developer, a registered private developer,
ask them in the search, let your surveyor be certain about what document they have, the identity of that document. If everything comes back straight, you don't need social search for estate, for private estate development land, because they are always in an enclave, surroundings, and all that. And you always see their salary and all that. They are not in plot or two plots, they are in acres and hectares. So, in that wise, the legal search goes a long way. Ask them what document they have. If they tell you this document is coming on the way, they are waiting for it from the governor to sign it and stuff, my brother, just hold your money or go to the next one. Hold your money, they sense that. They might get that document, don't get me wrong.
But as long as you are buying without them getting it, that might be, you might be getting what you paid for.
What you see is what you buy. So if you are paying in part or such, and eventually they didn't get the land from, they didn't get the required document from the government, and everything come out in disaster, you have just lost your money. So but that is for the private developers. If you are dealing with the third party, I mean somebody who owns the land directly themselves, either by virtue of family right, or somebody who has bought it from the first buyer and is trying to transfer his ownership to you, don't pay in part. If you can, don't pay in part. No more yalagbajari, it doesn't mean she cannot defraud you.
I've seen cases, we go to court every day on land matters. My lawyer used to tell me stories about crazy court statements. And the moment your landed property case is in court, both left and right must vacate the premises. Nobody is the rightful owner unless the person that owns the genuine document. And mind you, if you have not paid this third party person in full, he or she will not release the document to you.
Every other thing you have paid to him,
he might either say you paid him for the service he rendered to you, or you are paying for the loan that he or she has given to you in the past. And so many stories. People can be so dynamic like weather. You might say, okay, I wonder if you own you. You needed money so that they can send their brothers abroad, they can send their children abroad, they need you to pay 2.5 for the landed property and pay the rest when you have it. Don't do it. If you cannot afford to pay it outrightly, please don't do it. Outrightly, I mean you pay, you sign the necessary document, and you get the original from the seller and become the rightful owner and take physical possession immediately. We are not talking about bread and beans. We are talking about landed property.
Because the person that need money today might not need it tomorrow and will say, I'm not selling that land again. There's a case
in the private estate in Yanoku. I have a client. who is about selling a plot of land, two plots, sorry,
worth 70 million. When I was doing my search before I
pick everything up, I got to know that this same guy who claimed to own this land bought it in instrumental proceeding from the former seller, from the former owner. The owner had not transferred the documents to him. So he's trying to sell it now,
raise the money that he balance so he can pay the guy and get the original document. Do you see
that? I'm smelling trouble. So if he now goes to this guy, maybe for adventure, this guy knows that he's trying to sell the land.
You just come to him and say, okay,
the money you have paid so far is not afford. I'm no more selling my land. And you can go to whatever court you want to go. Whosoever owns the document owns the land. So if you are buying such a property, you are just, it's like buying a car without an engine.
How can you do? So it's not advisable to pay in part.
But the development, developer of
large acres of land, acres and estate, they have scheme, they do promos,
which are genuine. I'm not saying all of them are not genuine, but make sure you verify everything. But in most cases, what you pay for is not what you get, even with the developer.
They will say, pay 66,000 every month, and at the end of the 2 years of your salary structure, you get a plot of land.
By that end of the 2 years, where will they be?
How reliable are they? How long have they been in the business?
What kind of tax do they have? Do they have estates where they are fully developed, or they are just starting the last one? If you are starting to own a car by buying it, then in part, you are not ready to have a car. If you are really ready to have it, you are a mechanic, you must be able to point to cars you have fixed in the past, and your past experiences will speak for you. So if you really want to pay in part to an estate developer who say promo 50,000 every month, 6,000 every month, first thing you need to do is verify who these developers are, what kind of title do they have on the land, are they using our money to procure paper from the government, have they gotten the right papers from the Ministry of Lands yet, are they licensed to be in that place, is it free of government acquisition, when all these things come back here, then you have to question their integrity, are they somebody that will say one thing today and do something else tomorrow. Such cases are full in Lagos courts now. A lot of cases like that in Lagos, and at the end of the day, it is your money that is at stake, not theirs.